see it later if they want to. And so, okay, we've had, I don't know, I guess basically we've had issues with a whole bunch of things. So let me ask a couple of questions for those of you that are here. And I got to get you guys enabled here. And Newt Nerd is one of the main people talking on this thread that I want to talk about that's in our Steam group. Apparently your house got destroyed overnight.
Yeah, yet again it's been completely broken into. All our stone is gone. All of our chests are emptied.
Can you tell me?
Pretty much demolished everything.
And when you say demolished, I mean like your walls are gone, or the roof's gone, or
the stone walls are gone. The only thing standing is the wood.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Did they take your crest down?
They did.
Okay. So, how many people are in your guild or group?
Five or six.
Five or six, and did none of them were on whenever this happened?
No.
I suppose that we need a way to talk to our guild mates without giving stuff away, I guess. But when one of your guild is on and the rest of you are not, do you guys have communication between all of you? Or is it just in-game?
No, we have our own separate team speak.
Okay. because I guess what I'm trying to figure out here is that if someone is breaking the rules... like hardcore rules, like role play, which is a whole nother subject, but role play is hard to determine who's breaking rules on that and who's not. Sometimes there's a huge gray area in that area, but in the area of trebucheting or using ballistas on someone else's home and taking it down and all of that, it's very, very clear that we updated the rules to say that basically both parties need to agree, and they need to agree publicly in the game. And so if you hear trebuchet action and they're not hitting the king's castle, then it's most likely some sort of violation. And my first thought is that it's required for all of us as players to figure out who it is that's attacking someone else without consent and to turn them in.
Yeah. And I understand there's no logging system for that. You
none
to find it.
None.
So, I mean, I get that, but it's also hard when there's you and your wife are the only ones that are the actual admins. So when you're not around, I mean, it's hard for us to even make sure that anything is being done to police.
Right.
People not doing that. I agree on that.
Now, Tenchi sent me a message last night. I think that, it was Callisto. Is Callisto here? Yes. He's got his mic muted. Callisto, are you able to talk with us?
Yeah.
Excellent. Now, you said that you put up a server yourself, and that you were actually able to give administrative powers to people in degrees. Is that correct?
No, it wasn't me.
It wasn't you. Okay, let me see who sent me that, because somebody said that they figured out how to give... Oh, it's Yersius. Yersius. Is Yersius here? Let's see here. Let me see if he's even watching the show. He's not. He's not here right now. Which is too bad, because here's something that he said. He said, I can change a lot of things in the settings, like how many players can get in, you know, the whitelisted. And then the nicest thing of all is I can give people admin power, but for example, give them the power of only banning people. You can choose what admin commands can be at their use, and even create multiple admin ranks with less or more power. I think we need to figure that out, because that removes a lot of my objections for making others admin. Because there's a lot of people that I would trust with banning people, and then we can review them later if we want to.
I'm setting up a 7.0 to test Ed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, that's definitely something you, as the overall server host, need, is to be able to check up on your admins. I come from running game servers myself in the past, so I know how big a deal that is to be able to trust your admins, and that you have to absolutely check up on them.
Absolutely. There needs to be a balance on them, and then the only balance on me is all of you. But you know, I'm not doing anything. But anyway, that's a whole other story, I guess. But if we can do this, then certain people can be given the ability to ban, and we can get a good coverage. And but then, you know, those people or whatever, if someone's banned, we'll just have some sort of report that needs to be written up, and we post it in the forum, and that way we know what happens, because there's nothing worse than someone getting banned and then no one knowing why, because there is no admin logs on any of that as well, and it doesn't the stuff that I've looked at doesn't tell which admin or which person did it, but if we can do these groups, then we can also have the whitelist stuff, which is you know, for adding people to whitelist, but maybe also removing people, which is effectively banning someone, so that will give us more control. As it stands right now, I really wish that, I don't know, is there any of the devs here watching? If there are, speak up in chat, and you're welcome to get on TeamSpeak with us. And because, I mean, I'll state this publicly, but it's all your fault. I mean that in a very honest and sincere way. I'm not trolling you. It is a fact that this game was released before these tools were mature enough to be used in public. And that's a really big issue. Because we're trying to build something here that is built around your game and that is, you know, selling a lot of copies of your game. And the lack of these few tools in the game is destroying the community and getting people to just walk away and pissing me off. So, you know, it's that's just where it's at.
Even if they're not watching live stream right now, perhaps we can sit down and come up with a suggestion list that we send to them.
I can tell you that my last thing got zero response from them. Now I did post in the forums, and they did in the next patch, they implemented two things that I recommended. Now other people recommended those things as well. You know, it may have just been that I was just thinking along the same lines of what was needed, and I was just one of the many people who voiced it. So I don't think I got any special attention on that. Yeah, so there's no logs to see who banned who. Whatwid says that there is certain roles. And so I think that so I've added some more roles. In fact, I added another one last night. After we all talked, and it was adults only. I was watching Sorry About Your Faces stream and seeing him talk to some kid with a squeaky voice, and I'm like, that's just asking for trouble, having kids on. And so I added adults only, and if we've got any kids on there, I just need to know who they are and I can remove them. So, and I don't care if their feelings are hurt. And it should be apparent that I'm willing to ban anybody that's perceived as a problem. 'Cause I even banned one of my subscribers.
One of your mods.
And one of my mods. Yes, he's a mod. I didn't remember that, but yes, you're right. He's a mod. So, you know, that's been resolved and he's back now and it shouldn't be an issue. But I just wanted to put that out there that it doesn't matter who the person is, you know, if we're putting trust in you and or you're being a problem, I want this to work and we'll remove the problems. So
just throwing it out there too, if you do end up getting these permissions that worked out and end up assigning other admins, probably be better to keep them, you know, under wraps, like not let everyone know who the admins are. Just it'd be easier to keep tabs on people that way.
Yes and no, because we need the admins need to be, because here's what's going to come up is that someone's going to post in game, is there an admin here? I've got a problem. You know, person that responds, you know, most likely is an admin at that point.
Well, they would need to post, you know, on the forum with the problem, go through official channels.
Maybe. But when you've got somebody who's doing an exploit or attacking somebody without provocation or attacking another, you know, structure or whatnot, the person needs to be there to see it.
Understandable.
Unfortunately, we can't go off of. Why am I hearing myself?
Next problem.
Go ahead.
You are running into the next problem because you don't see the opponent's name who's shooting with a trebuchet, for example, on you.
We are going to change that. So with this last patch, it can be on for everybody. I just don't know how to do it.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
And we're gonna turn names on for everybody, so everybody sees all names. I can do it with a command, but I don't know what I'm supposed to do in the server. And I was told they said that this next patch was going to introduce that. Well, I think it's an administrative option that, you know, requires editing of some file on the server. So because it didn't work when we wiped, which is what I expected would happen. So, so no teens on the server, dick move. The epic monster, yeah, well, sorry I'm a dick. I mean, I want people who are mature on the server. You know, we all have enough difficulties with our own children. We don't need everybody else's children being a difficulty for us as well.
Ding ding.
Let's talk about PvP a little bit and the rules.
Well, let's.
I think that's a biggie.
Are we done with this subject?
Welcome
though?
To the dragons.
You know, I don't even know what to call this subject that we were just on, but it started with how's structures getting attacked by trebuchets middle of the night, and which I assume it was trebuchets or ballistas.
I think it was more that they broke into the base, tore down the crest, and then replaced that with their own crest, then took all the materials that they felt were
of worth
to gather.
Right. Yeah. Well, either way, you're not supposed to attack structures without the other person being there. Isn't that in the rules?
Of course.
Yeah,
and I can tell you exactly what happened with the first time on my original base before the wipe.
Mm-hmm.
Is someone came in, I did not know, because I just started playing a few days ago. I did not know that the wooden walls could just be knocked down by hand. I found that out after the fact.
Mm-hmm,
well,
mm-hmm.
When I was offline, someone came in, went to my wall that was up against the side of the hill, which was wooden, knocked down two blocks, got into the base, and looted everything.
Yeah.
There were none of my members online. I've 100% verified that. So that's what happened there. The second time, basically it was that they came in through the roof and somehow knocked stuff in the roof,
mm-hmm.
and got in. I don't know how they did that one, but they did get in that way.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So, And one of the things that I don't want to take out is I don't want to take out the ability to attack structures. I want that to be in there, but we just need it to be more consensual.
Agreed.
And so it's up to everybody in game to be the police. We have more and more people in. We had the highest amount of people on yesterday. In fact, I was kind of upset because I talked about making a 30-man server. And then, you know, we wiped. And you know how many people we had on after we wiped? We had like 37 on. And we weren't having much lag problems with that many people. So it's not really the people. It's the items, I think, in the game. So anyway, I ordered a 40-man server and it'll be ready on Saturday. I don't know. All we can do is do our best at policing it. And if you see something going on, we need evidence. And
screenshot.
Yeah, a screenshot or video or multiple people. I'm a little leery of taking just one person's word for it. I know some of you well. I know a lot of you just casually, and I want to make sure that when we take action to ban someone, that we're that we've, how do you put it, that we trust the information that we have as best as possible as being accurate and proper. Because some people will get very emotional and say things, even though it's not true. And I'm just taking that into account as a normal human behavior. And, you know, it doesn't mean that they're bad people or whatnot. It's just that if we're going to ban somebody, I want to do it right. And that should be, everyone should appreciate that as well. Because that way, somebody can't be mad at you and say, well, he was doing this, and then you get instantly banned just because one person says it. And goes both ways. So we need some sort of proof. Second person, video, screenshot, whatever. And it should be posted in, like, right now, or like our general discussion forum. You know, it's very public. I know this, but at the same time, that way, if someone's posting something that's bullshit, somebody else will call it out, other than the one that's being accused. Does that sound fair, or does that sound right, or what's your thoughts, guys?
I'll be definitely recording everything from now on.
Yeah, I think that's just the way to go. We're going to be doing the same thing.
So, just put up a YouTube video or whatever. Yeah.
I want to kind of talk about our first encounter with New Nerd. New Nerd, you're the Knights Who Say Knee, right?
Yes.
Okay, I want to talk about our first encounter yesterday when it was you and a couple buddies. You were at your base. And it was a couple of our buddies coming up to your base. I want to go over that, and I want to ask you what we did wrong or what we should do differently or something like that. Because in our minds, if you're at your base, you are there defending your stuff while you're online. And also, I want to put it into play that when we came up on your base, we didn't break any blocks. We played the game mechanics, and we didn't destroy anything, and we never ever loot someone completely dry. And that's just but I want to talk about coming up on your base and what you think should be changed, and because we're only using the game ourselves. We're not hacking, destroying blocks, we're not killing sleepers, we're following all the rules, especially when it comes to bases like that. And if we see you at your base, I don't understand how engaging or you know is what brings that into play. Is are we on a PvE server or are you just, do we need to post on the forums that hey, we're going to be coming by your base on Thursday, get ready to defend it? Because we didn't destroy anything, we didn't do anything like that. I just kind of want to get your feel of sense of how we I feel like we did you wrong.
I'll play Judge Judy.
Please.
I'm just kidding.
First of all, I never said I guess I did accuse you earlier, but I apologize for that. That was just my.
I feel like the president. I know how he feels assumption. Now when people say thanks Obama. You know, I feel like we're just, you know, we get all the blame.
No, and I get it. I did jump to that conclusion, and that was wrong of me. So I do apologize for that. It could have happened after you guys got off. I don't know when it happened. I feel your or pain. Who did it, but
I appreciate that though. I do.
As far as the role play, I heard your flutes as you were approaching. So I immediately ran to the roof to actually see if I could engage with somebody because nobody had really been by our base yet. I was actually looking forward to some roleplay. All that happened was I felt like I was being kind of yelled at by little kids, which I get was your aspect of roleplay. And then you climbed my wall and attacked me. There was barely even any chance for me to respond. I was trying to talk over voice. And I don't know if you didn't hear me or what was going on with that, but I have been told that I apparently sound very low in game. I don't know why, considering you can hear me perfectly fine on TeamSpeak.
Absolutely. I'm just thinking maybe we're all talking at once or something.
Also, lag does interrupt voice. We could see that really big on the server war. Including Jay-Z said like 30 times, find the flag in a row. It just kept looping over and over and over again.
Just the way I look at it is this, okay? I come from a background of playing back in the day in Ultima Online when there was a large roleplay community on those servers. Mm-hmm. I was part of the Atlantic roleplay community. And we did PvP fights all the time. But the requirement for it was that there had to be some sort of interaction between the two parties because we ran into the same problem of people would say, oh, I'm a role player murderer, so I don't have to talk to you. I'm just going to run up and kill you. And we had to basically make rules against that there has to be some actual talking back and forth between the two.
Dialogue?
Groups. Yeah, mm-hmm. Actual dialogue. Sorry, phone.
Love that ringtone.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, dialogue includes, not just... I could see how you might think that communication would be, okay, we're all playing our flutes, everyone can hear us coming, there's no denying that. And so they know that we're going to engage with them or whatever. But dialogue would require speaking to and getting a response back. And you know, it might be that you're blowing your war horns and they blow their war horns back and okay, battle on, you know. But
I agree. In that case we just must have not, because we were saying things like come with us and we're gonna take you with us and all this other stuff and do you want to join and all this stuff, and we're just seeing you guys just stand there. Like, just not even moving, just stand there, nothing in chat. And, I mean, it's, like, four or five guys, like, saying stuff, trying to open up conversation. And after the third minute, if you guys are just standing there and not saying anything, we want to come engage. We want to come do something. We want to have fun, you know? It's just, that's why I think we should distinguish PvP rules, PvE rules. Someone on the forum had a great idea. If you are completely neutral or you are aggressive or something like that, put it right in your guild name, so when people see your name, especially if Markee adds that thing where you see everybody's name at all time, it'll say neutral, it'll say hostile, it'll let you know everybody what's going on. But it's either we're not hearing each other or
Ultima Online, going back to the Ultima Online thing, it did a pretty good job of showing this, because if you were neutral you were gray, is that right? And if you were hostile you were red. And then I forget what the positive was, but basically your alignment equaled your actions, and that may not be a bad idea. I don't know. I'm not sure how to enforce that. But when you see reds walking down the road toward you, you know immediately you need to be defensive. But if you see blues or whatever the positive color is, you know that most likely you're going to be able to talk to them and you know, come away with a more positive experience. Not sure how that could work, but
if I could throw something in here, like having personally played literally hundreds and hundreds of hours on roleplay servers on like DayZ RP and Altus Life and Arma 3 Life and whatnot. All these servers have rules about mutual roleplay. It's not, you can't have one-sided roleplay. Like, you can't just go up to a place and if you receive absolutely no, you know, interaction, you can't just go kill them. Like,
Does that not fall under RDM? Because I went and looked at Altus Life Asylum's rules, and they actually only have one rule, no RDM.
Well,
right.
I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
Well, I was just saying you need some kind of mutual interaction there. And if there's people screaming over the mic, you know, that doesn't allow the chance for mutual role play, then what's the point?
Like, you got to say you can't hear us then or something, or say we're being too loud in chat. Not saying anything is just, I don't think the answer.
Okay. Easy King, you got a hot mic. We're hearing you. You got to put on a headset.
Sorry, I'm back.
It kind of brings up one point, and that's communication. And so communication is a must. And so if we are taking this to like role play rules or whatever, which, you know, I'm not a very good role player. I attempt. Some people think I do fine. I never feel like I do okay, though. And if we, you know, say, okay, well, there must be a dialogue. There must be, you know, you spit something out, something comes back, you know, to where there's communication. You can't have one-sided communication. There's no such thing. And so if we have that, then you're fair to take it wherever you want. What do we do with people who do not have mics?
I went as far as saying they shouldn't even be in the server, but I know that's going to offend so many people. And
I actually agree.
I think they just should not be allowed in the server whatsoever. But so many people I'm friends with in the server don't have mics, and I feel extremely...
They need to go out and buy one.
I need to be the one to say it, but that is just how numerous people I've talked to feel about it.
You can't role play without a mic. How does Altus Life take care of that in their rules, you know?
You need a mic.
Yeah. This isn't Ultima Online where the words appear over your head.
Exactly.
And they appear down in chat. And I can tell you that when I'm busy doing something, I don't always see chat, especially me doing admin stuff. You guys, if I don't answer you, it doesn't mean that I'm ignoring you. Well, it actually does mean I'm ignoring you. And I'm ignoring you because I'm doing admin stuff. I could chat all day. I get chatted up all the time when I go in. But I think it's hard to role play over chat. And unless both parties are chatting, then it's expected. And I don't have any problem with putting in a rule that you must have a mic. I think that would improve the quality and communication of things quite a bit, and there'd be less miscommunication if everyone had a mic.
I agree.
The only real problem with that is how are you going to verify it?
Well, if they just start typing in chat and not using a mic, then there you go. That's the person that's not using a mic. It'll just have to be one by one.
Yeah.
And that would be that, you know, I'll add to the rules that you must have a mic, and then we can be a little lenient on people the next few days. If people who it's really important to play here, if they really want to play, they'll figure out getting a mic. If it's not so important to them, then they won't do it, and you know. Maybe that rule can go. We can remind everybody right now, and on Saturday when we put in the new server, then it'll be in effect. Which, by the way, the new server will come in on Saturday. The current server is going to go full out nuts PvP. I just got a role play, but you guys can all attack the shit out of each other, or whatnot, until the server goes down on the 14th.
I think the underlying factor here is that, well, at least to me, okay, like, I'm not a Care Bear by any means.
But, welcome, Elder Dragon.
You know, we're a community.
So,
like,
you think you're worthy of being a Markee Dragon subscriber?
What's
the hold
Duke
on, hold
isn't
on
so
just
sure
second.
Of that.
JJ.
Get in line with the other dragons
Duke
and show me what you're made
you.
Of. What are you waiting for? Get over there before I open a can of whoop ass.
Sorry, Duke, Bolinko, thank you for subbing. It caused Duke to totally talk over you, JJ, so say that again while I give Bolinko some gold and then everybody else some gold for Bolinko subbing. So continue on. As you were start at the beginning of what you were saying.
Okay. Basically, what I was saying is just that, you know, we're supposed to be a community here. I'm not a Care Bear. I don't expect to have no combat, but it's the way people are, you know, steamrolling people. And, you know, you run around in a large group and you just, you know, basically have your way. No matter what role play comes around, you're still going to have your way because you're that big of a group against, you know, a small group. But anyway, that aside, like, we're supposed to be a close-knit community. We're not supposed to be here trolling each other and trying to, like, give grief to everyone. Like, it's supposed to be a friendly server. Otherwise, what's the point of having the whitelist? You know, that's my opinion.
The whitelist is nothing about being friendly, just so everybody knows. The whitelist is about keeping exploiters off the server.
And I'm glad you brought up griefing too, because we should talk about that as well.
Well, let me just say too that I want to kill every single person that I come across, and that may sound, you know, I want to PvP. That's what I really enjoy doing. I suck at it, but it's what I want to do, and I love going through servers killing people, and I know that may sound very antisocial or whatnot, but you know I want to be able to PvP with people a lot. And but I also recognize that other people don't want that experience, and so we got to find the balance on that, and that's the tough part. But I want to be able to be an asshole on the server, but do it well during with role play, but yes. You know, like, be the best asshole I can be.
Like, for example, on DayZ RP, you can be an asshole and be a PvPer all you like. It's just within the logical outcome of the roleplay. Like, if, you know, use the logical outcome. If somebody submits to you, don't kill them anyway. You know what I mean?
Well, and just to throw this out there to give you some, like, idea of where my aggravation with the Pied Piper group came from.
Mm-hmm.
Just the day before, prior to the wipe, I had been out gathering resources, and King Roloff, or whatever his name was, and one of his groupies came through, and basically they challenged me. I interacted with them. They demanded my loyalty, and when I refused, they started attacking and killed me.
Mm-hmm.
Well, first they tried to rope me. When they couldn't do that and I started fighting back, they killed me. Okay, cool. That happens. Not a big deal. So then I obviously respawn. I run around some other areas trying to gather some resources. They come across me again. Well, I see them before they ever get to me. They're
welcome
all wearing full
to the
plate.
Dragons.
I've got basically nothing on. Somehow they were able to run me down and basically still did the same thing. They claimed
welcome
to be role-playing,
to
but it was just, hey, you stop. Hey, you stop. I mean, it wasn't no actual, like, role-play involved. And because I recognized them before, of course I'm from before, of course I'm going to try to run away. I
mm-hmm,
mean,
mm-hmm.
Why would I not when you killed me before? So they chased me pretty much across, like, half the map, all the way back towards my base. They managed to rope me and then drug me around for about an hour, talking all kinds of junk to me. And when I just ended up stopping talking to them at all, they started talking junk to me about that.
There's a couple of
killing me again.
There's a couple of things I'm thinking of here on. I refer a lot to Asylum on how they do a lot of things because they seem to have some pretty good rules and it's really good role play there. And One of the things is that when you have someone captured, I think you can't hold them for more than 5 minutes. Is that right? Or something like that?
Yeah.
And
that would be reasonable.
And after 5 minutes, you have to kill them or let them go.
Yep.
One of the two. And it sucks getting killed. I can tell you that that Cass's guys, can't tell you how many times I got roped. And I quit trying to go get resources because I was getting freaking roped every time. Yeah. And it just kind of pissed me off, but I don't know. I mean, there is this.
Well, that's what I mean. Like, you gotta play the RP. Like, make your actions based on the logical outcome of the roleplay.
Yes, you know, I have a hard time saying to anybody that you can't use a mechanic that's within the game. And I really, so, you know, the obvious thing is if ropes are pissing most people off, remove ropes. But I don't think we can say that. And
no, it's the same like lockpicks. You cannot remove them. They're a part
right.
of the game.
Now, is it true that if you put the stone up your butt that you can't be roped?
It breaks the rope, and I agree yeah. that roping on site should not happen, and I talked to all of them about that last night, and numerous times, and we've gone over it over and over again, but you can't control everybody, and that's just the way Earth is, and...
No,
let me go further back on this. If you use the stone, can you be roped?
No, it breaks the rope.
Okay, so fine. Everybody stick a stone up your butt, and we're all good.
You can even stack the stones. You can have like a stack of like 9 stones up your butt.
Wow.
That hurts.
Yeah, yeah. Now you're getting into transport quantities for resale.
now you're Marcus, talking Markee's language.
Not safe for work.
To the permission things, I sent you changed permission codes that I was working on now. So a different group was added, the moderator group, without all the permissions that you have as an admin. So you need to try that out. If it is working, if not, I will revise the code.
Yeah, I'll look at that. We'll look at that off air. But thank you for doing that up, and we'll test it. I have the new server available. Maybe I can test it on there before we make it live on Saturday. So, anyway, if this is real simple, if rock up the butt counters rope,
they put
then
it in
everybody stick that rock up your ass, and we call it good. If you get roped, it's your own fault at that. Okay. Easy. I'm sorry. You keep repeating my words.
I want to. Oh, my bad.
Does that sound, I mean, am I being unfair by saying that if you don't like to be roped, stick the rock up your butt?
Nope.
Not at all.
It's okay. Part of the game.
It is part of the game. And so every time someone bitches about getting roped, the answer is, stick that rock up your ass. I love saying this. Stick that rock up your ass, and you'll be okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is not safe for work.
So, no, but there we go.
People that are upset with raiding groups and the word griefing and people that are saying griefing, I want to say this. The first 5 minutes of the server... And I have nothing against this. I mean, it's aggravating,
welcome
but it's, again,
the
way the game was made. First 5 minutes of the server, a group goes up to the King's Tower with blocks. They take the King's ship. They block everything off, and they put a crest down. They put taxes at 20%.
Welcome
and
to
that
the
right there means that we do not want to go out and get resources right now. What else can we do if we can't build and we can't go get resources? We want to go around and have fun with people. And fun is rotating in a game that is all about PvP. So we want to incorporate roleplay into that, to where everybody, you guys, and I'm going to talk with them tonight, we're going to make it our roleplay a lot better, but we're going to still keep that Pied Piper thing, but we're going to, you know, add on to it a little bit. But for a game that
every time you slam your desk with your fist,
I'm sorry, I'm just getting into it. it just makes us salty, because what is more griefing than I have no problem with large groups. If you guys have something against large groups, you need to just say something in chat and team up with people. But For somebody that in the first 5 minutes blocks off the King's Tower, makes 20% resources, we're not going to go get resources right now. We're going to go do something else that the game offers.
I can tell you that that's a real dick move. And I've heard other, I watch other streamers and I've seen them right when the server comes up and somebody goes and does that. And their instant thing is just like you, it's not like we have the gear to go kill them and stuff. It's like, I can't believe what dicks they are and what dick move. And I'm going to remember that type of thing. And so, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to do. There's nothing we can do in the game mechanics. So, but maybe it should be that, you know, real simple suggestion for the devs. The first hour, it can only go up to 1%. Second hour, it can only go up to 2% until that server's 20 hours old, and then it can be full 20%. Something like that. And that solves the problem programmatically.
Yeah, also gotta keep in mind it's still an alpha, so every issue we find is.
It is okay. You know what? I have to say, it doesn't matter if it's alpha. They chose to release the game to the public, and they want us to buy it. It's fully released. There's no more alpha beta bullshit. I'm getting really irritated with that. Not at you, but I'm just getting really irritated when people keep putting out this crap and expecting us to buy it, and then us suffering for this. And if you better put it out, even for free, I don't like it out. And the reason is because we want to play the games that are interesting when they first come out. Don't bring them out until they're done. Simple as that. Another game publisher that I'm working with brought the biggest piece of shit out. I cannot believe how bad it is. And I knew it would insult the hell out of him, though, if I told him what I thought. That, like, the dumbass, this is... You know, this is the kind of stuff that causes bankruptcies, you know, that you spend all this money on a game and you bring it out and there's three fucking people playing it. That's all that was in all of the servers. They had hundreds of servers and there was three people total in all of the servers because the game is that bad. Anyway, okay, off of my stool. Continue on.
Good point, though. Absolutely. But that's just how I feel. If stuff like that in-game is in place, it will make people want to just run around and do other stuff that the game has in store for it. I don't know really how else to put it.
Mm-hmm.
Can I ask something?
Yeah,
of course.
Can we divide the server in two parts, PvP 1 and Care Bear 1?
Yeah. Okay, so I'm really glad you asked that, because I think that's a really important point. My wife likes Care Bear, I like PvP. And we've had this talk back and forth many times over the last week about how to resolve this issue, and we have not come to a consensus that both of us look at and go, this is perfect. And part of the problem is that she likes to see all the conflict, she just doesn't want to be in it. And I get it. But I had two solutions. One is that we put up two servers. We have one that's PvP and we have one that's not. And then it's two communities, but they can both live in the kind of harmony that they want. And, you know, anybody's, you know, being a dork on one of them, they get banned from both. Because I'm mirroring all the whitelists. If we have multiple servers, they're all going to be the same whitelist. And I'm not going to try and manage who's banned from what. That's not going to work. And so, you know, so that's one solution, is that we have a couple of servers. And the other solution is that we actually separate a portion of the land for being non-PvP and non-anything that can impact your home.
I think everyone will just build in that area and run over in PvP in the other.
Badlands will be PvP.
You know, I'll build out in the PvP area, and I'll build, you know, I'll have just this tiny little room that'll have just a couple of chests in my crest, but my walls will be 20 bricks thick, you know? Because I know everybody's going to trebuchet the shit out of me overnight, you know? I don't know. We can have both. It won't be hard for me to put up another server that is, you know, no PvP. and it just won't be the server that I'm playing on.
I feel people are going to join. I absolutely think we should do this, but I also feel that people are going to join the PvP server, and there will still be some complaints. I see complaints.
Of course, when anyone gets killed, they're upset.
All the time, constantly.
If you want to gather materials, maybe the don't kill naked guy. If you want to get materials, you will be naked only with hatchet or whatever.
People will just be naked 24/7. I mean, there's
exactly.
Just,
yeah.
There's mm-hmm. just things that, like when we had that war. I mean, maybe you heard me in game, maybe you didn't, but we were saying, "Don't kill the naked guys. Don't kill the naked guys. Don't kill the naked guys."
And I didn't understand that because I'm like, "You should kill me because I'm killing you."
Well, that's just everybody puts us out to be this huge bad guys that loot and steal and just do all this stuff. But when it comes down to it, we do not go all out like some groups coming around. You guys are. I mean. And then, I don't know, it's just, but that has nothing to do with anything. It's just...
Yeah. Actually, there's a really good question in chat, which is, and what is it that you would do on a PvE server?
Exactly. It's just...
Build.
Okay.
Gathering flux.
I just want my huge tower.
Killing
right.
chickens.
You want your lag. Okay, so we are one of the things that we're going to try is that we have this new server coming in on Saturday, and it's just going to be our general server. It'll be 40 man, and it'll have our current rules as they are. Then probably about a week after that, I'm bringing on a special server, and we will know by then what it is we're going to do on that server. I'm going to post some stuff that we can try. One of the things is building and everything, and my wife really lit up whenever I said, you know, we put it into creative mode and then really just unlimited resources, and everybody builds to their heart's desire, you know, some excellent creations, and we go in and judge them or whatever. I don't know. But we also can try some hardcore PvP. We can try, you know, red versus blue. We can try you know, all kinds of different things. And then anything that works really well on there, maybe we'll put that in on the main server. The other thing is we could, you know, it's possible to put up another server that's just PvE.
Okay, I just want to speak up a little bit in regards to that. I feel like there's a misconception going in about PvE, Care Bears, whatever. I am absolutely not a Care Bearer. I enjoy PvP. I love it. I don't care if I die. I don't care if I lose all my stuff. We went and because, as I said before, I feel like people were basically doing things to bend the rules as much as possible. Just a perfect example of this. How many midgets are there running around the server right now? And the only true reason for being a midget is because you know you're harder to hit because you're a smaller target.
It has all to do with our RP, bro. And I'm not, I don't want to sit here and call you out.
No, I'm not. Actually, I'm not even referring to your group. I've run across probably a half dozen, or I'd actually say a dozen midgets other than your group just because it's focused on combat.
Then hit up the devs and tell them, why did you put this in your game? Because they did it on purpose for a reason, because they wanted it to be in their game. And I feel that they did the boosting thing on purpose. I feel that they let you stand on top of other players on purpose because there's walls in their game.
And that's the advantage. And is that then the advantage of the taller players, where midgets, it takes three of them instead of two regular-sized people?
It's the same jump height.
Well, that's a mistake. Yeah. I don't know.
I blame the fat midgets.
See, in my opinion, if you're a midget, you should do less damage. I mean, you're a midget.
But this isn't. This is. I mean, now we're getting into like, you don't like the way our characters are. It's all these different little things. And if we were to come up with a rule for all these little different things that we're talking about, I mean, we want to be a community and be helpful. If we didn't give a shit, we wouldn't be here right now talking about it. But if we're going to go through every little thing and say, okay, your character has to be 6'7" with blue eyes and you can't walk around between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m., the game is going to be dead and boring for us in a month. We just need to find a way.
I think you're taking it a little bit too far. there.
Yeah. This is the way the game is, and if you perceive that that midgets are an advantage, then you should be a midget too.
Exactly.
I don't know how else to put it.
And yeah.
Then we need to take the RP tag off the server. My opinion.
Why? Because we can't be midgets?
Whatever. I'm dropping out then.
Oh, I don't know what to say.
All right, well, I know that we can't please everybody. It's just not 100% possible. But, you know, I guess I don't understand what's so important about midgets or not.
We really did it so we look like children, I promise.
Jay-Z, okay, Jay-Z, not asking you. Asking new nerd. Okay.
Go ahead.
What's important about midget or not midget, and why is it a problem?
It's not important. I don't know. It's not important, man. Just go on.
Well, I mean, if there is something real legitimate, I wanna identify that. If it's just, you know, I don't know. The more information that I have, the better decisions that I can make. And I can tell you that I don't understand this one. And if you say just drop it, well then fine. But I don't understand it.
I don't know. It would seem to me that people make themselves midgets and of dark color just to exploit game mechanics. That's my opinion.
Yes, the darker the skin, the more stealthy you are. Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
So that was something I saw day one. You know, I couldn't see the black guys at night. You know?
But you could during the day.
Yeah, but still, you can see the white guys much better. And in fact, my character now does not have bright face paint anymore because I felt like it was attracting too many people. It made myself too visible.
Yeah, you could see the green from miles away.
Right. I didn't like that watermelon face. I mean, it was fun for a minute, but then Halloween was over. You know, if I was playing totally competitive, see, I play characters that I identify with, and so I build my characters kind of in the way I identify with, and so I wouldn't make myself a black midget because I don't identify with that very well. But I do see the competitive advantage of that 100%, because you're harder to see and harder to hit. But, you know, if I was willing to do that, then I could do that. But I'm not, so.
I think you're on the right track with the PvE and PvP server. Unfortunately, I hope that doesn't make you spend more money, but I think we can do donations and make it work. But I think that's the way it'll go, or should be. That's just my 2 cents. I think that'll stop a lot of the complaints, hopefully.
Yeah. I think about this in terms of Eve too, because like Eve is very harsh, and in Eve, you know, killing people and robbing them and all of this stuff is a way of life. But I also think though that there's not as much role play in Eve, and we're trying to do something a little bit different here. We're not playing this as a first person shooter where you come around a corner, you see somebody, you shoot them. We're playing this more as role play, you know, as playing a character or playing a part. I can do a PvE server as opposed, you know, and a PvP server. My idea though of PvP is that you know, everybody builds fortresses that are impregnable to Trebuchet, and Trebuchets can be used all the time. And you know, you hide your stuff really well. You know, build your stuff in a valley under trees, and use that green moss brick on the top so that nobody sees it. Okay. Where are we at? What do we have? Do we have more subjects on this?
I don't know. I think we covered a lot of stuff.
So Tush in chat is saying there is no RP on the server.
All we do is RP. Even when we're with only in our guildies around, all we do is RP, even in voice chat.
There's RP? Okay, sure. You're RPing.
They just don't like
RP. Piper and, you know, little cannibal children that like to eat people. Okay, sure, I see that. But you have it in your head, okay, we are going to go to this guy and we are going to engage him. We don't care what kind of RP he has. We are still going to go and engage this guy, take him and eat him and kill him.
No, we want to take you back to our base. But if you say no and you
then
disengage,
you're going to attack and kill.
No, but we're going to rope and see where it goes. And that's, I didn't, that should be completely normal. We engage.
If you
had have
attempted to rope me, that would be true, but you never once did. You automatically attacked me.
And who is this? Who is this talking?
That was the new nerd. Not where? Once did you try to rope me.
And when was this? At your base? When we were scaling?
At my
it?
Base.
Well, you were at your base defending it. We're talking to you in-game for at least 2 to 3 minutes. And,
no, it was more like 30 seconds.
Nah,
if that.
Bro. No. But, okay. Again, you're there with your guild. You're at your base. We're here with our guild. I just... With the gray space, we don't understand.
Because
it's not
is...
like we went in there... We went in there and just jumped up there and killed you. We went up there and started looking at your stuff, and then you attacked. So, of course, I just...
I never once attacked anybody until I was already being swung at. I was standing on top of my base trying to talk down to you. And then, obviously, I guess you didn't hear what I was saying. I don't know. But
you heard what we were saying. So, we didn't see anything in chat.
All I could hear was the yelling of little kids, join us, come with us. That's all I heard.
You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of Hatfields and McCoys. I don't know how to resolve this. gosh.
My point is just, you know, what, it has to be mutual roleplay. You can't just go in with the objective, okay, we're going to do this to this person, and no matter what roleplay he comes out with, we're still going to do that to him. It just doesn't work. It's not roleplay.
Well, what happens? So let me ask this. If a bank robber walks into the bank intent on shooting people no matter what, even if he gets the money, and he gets the money or he doesn't, and he shoots people, that's like a real world scenario and everything. And roleplay is kind of playing out real world scenarios. Am I off on that?
No, I see what you're saying.
Or they could even be role-playing ISIS, you know, which is becoming the scourge of the planet.
But seriously? Really?
Well, no, I mean, I'm not saying that I would not put up with somebody saying they were ISIS on the server and going around and killing people. I would not put up with that, just like I wouldn't put up with Nazis or whatever. But I'm just kind of just saying that isn't role-play... Is there something else with role play that I don't understand other than you are playing a part of something that's like real or imaginary and you're trying to play whatever that is to its nth degree as good as you can?
I think as long as the reactions of both parties are logical to the role play, then it's okay. If one party disregards the other party's role play and continues on their own path anyway, then that's god modding.
Can you give Shy talk power and TeamSpeak? He's also with our group. I'm sure he's got some good points. I don't want to be the only one speaking for us. And a good part.
It's a good part. Well, it wasn't exactly to this, but I was thinking about the dividing the server. The map is so exactly quite big. There's a lot of the map not being used. For example, the desert to the right of the King Island, no one ever builds there, and there's just one rock. We could have like a PvE zone there.
Also, resources there, so.
There's no resources out there. There's nothing out there.
There's wheat, there's oil.
No, not out of the desert. I'm talking way out to the right where there's this huge fucking rock at the end.
Ah,
that's all there is.
Sorry, I thought you went to wheat field.
No, not the wheat field. I'm talking like way out there. There's nothing, and there's like a huge island out in the back where no one is as well because it's too far away from resources. There's some quite good places to be.
The island is usually taken. Chronic was there. I was there.
Oh, okay, I was just never out there.
Like I said, I wouldn't split up the world in PvE and PvP segment parts. So, Jay-Z was saying it before, and I thought about that, that this would be a great idea. Just put a neutral or something like that.
I should have known those alien maggots booby-trapped this subscriber.
Not interested in PvP at all. If you are interested in PvP, just don't put a neutral or something like that in your corp ticker. Easy to deal with.
So
stop people from being douchebags still, because there are still douchebags in this server.
So you're suggesting putting something in the corp name that would identify.
Good name. Yes, if they want to do PvP or not. If they're neutral, they're not doing anything, and at least they should keep it that way so that they are not entering in PvP as well. Otherwise, it's a kind of bad situation there.
You can make your name with PvP or PvE in the end.
Every single person has a guild, whether they like it or not. I mean, all of us do. But does the guild show? No. It's only our character names that show.
Yeah.
And then the guild symbol. And so this has to be something done in the character's name.
Yeah, then just brackets, opening brackets here, PvP, and brackets closed at the end of the name. It's not a big deal, I think.
Oh, yeah, the player name. Yeah, that's
the easiest solution.
Everyone make a potion and just change your name.
If Markee puts the name visible all the time, it would be nice.
Yeah, we're going to put the name visible all the time. I'm going to figure that out. And the PvP thing, I think that this game is about PvP, that it is
exactly
one of its core functions to the game. And putting something in your name stating that you're eligible for PvP is not the answer. That if someone wants to refrain from PvP, then they put something in theirs that says no PvP. But because I think there's a lot more people here for PvP than not, and part of the problem too, though, is we get new players in. This is something I'm going to do, by the way, is that I think that there's a whole bunch of people that don't read the rules. They apply for the whitelist and everything, and they don't read the rules. And how do I know this? Because I can't even read the three sentences that say how to apply for the whitelist. and so they're constantly applying wrong or in the wrong place. Or I don't know if you guys have noticed those 40 people asking for access on the comments on the homepage that are just general comments on the group. I've ignored all of them. I'm going to put in the rules that and tell everyone they need to read the rules, and that they have to put the word like carrot or some piece of crap in their application, in their whitelist, and anyone who doesn't just gets it denied. It tells me that they don't care about the rules and they haven't read them. And this will help with our
sorting
fun.
Out.
This will help with our fun on the server. The second thing is how do we deal with this PvP thing? Because I want a PvP. I think that Lisa wants to PvP, but only sometimes. And how do we make sure that new people that come in know that this symbol or whatnot means don't attack me? They're going to get attacked anyway. And if we do it the flip side, where everybody puts PvP, if they're wanting PvP in it, well, then you've got a whole bunch of missed opportunity because you got a whole bunch of people that didn't read the rules and don't know about it. And so they're not putting that in there, and so they're never getting engaged, and they wonder why. And then they have to go out and try and make the potion, which, if you've been playing a little while, it's not too hard to make, but as a new player, it's very difficult.
If not PvP or PvE, it's PvP.
My wife says just don't attack naked people, but she's saying that in chat.
People are gonna abuse that, for sure. Mm-hmm. Run around naked and then backstab someone.
Right. Actually, you could do that, couldn't you? You could run around naked, you could have all of your armor in there, and then, you know, you're taunting somebody, or somebody pisses you off, so you put your armor on and you kill the other player. Oh, God. I wish they would just put shit in that would just take care of this in the game. It's all a game developer's fault. Why the fuck did you guys make a great game and then not give us any ability to administer it? There. I feel better now.
Yeah.
I like the name part where you change your name.
Well, I suppose that... So if we were going to try that, then, you know, any, I guess, what, I guess I'm more comfortable with people not putting something, or putting something in their name if they don't want PvP. And then if they decide they want to engage in PvP, they have to go change their name. They have to go make one of those potions.
Yep.
Which is not something that's probably easy, because you go to the character remodel screen for that. And it's not something that you could typically grief with. You couldn't, like, do it, like, right on the fly, like throwing armor on. If you know you're going to go out on a battle this weekend and you want to be engaged in PvP, then you know that you need a potion for this weekend so that you can add the, you know, or remove whatever. I don't know. I guess every time somebody gets killed and they don't want to, they can just blame the game developer. I don't know what else to do, because we've got all these different opinions. So, next topic. Yeah, like we'll think about that. Yeah, I don't know that we're going to get anywhere on that one. And so, next topic, and we'll... You know, if we have any new thoughts on it next time we're talking about the stuff, we'll bring it up. So, or if anybody has an aha moment and has it all figured out, you know, later, post it in the forums and we can discuss. Obviously, there's a lot of people engaged in the forums. We have like 50-some replies to the one post made last night. Any other subjects on making the game better?
Can we talk about the King's Hill?
What about it?
About the guys from last night after the what?
Jay-Z mentioned it, and I called them dicks. And so...
But that's pretty much it. I mean, it's just the way can the game
just,
is.
Yeah, but still, it just makes no sense. There's no RP in it. There's nothing in it at all.
There's no RP required to be king, just like there's no RP required to attack the king. The king is attackable 100% of the time from anywhere without communication, and including the king's castle can be trebucheted any time without any communication. So being king or being up there, being on the bridge is a very dangerous place. That is 100% PvP zone.
Last time I jumped at one.
Yeah, I saw that. And so, you know, it's not right that they do that, and I have no control over it either. And I don't want to make a rule for it, because it just means that everybody needs to band together and upgrade your weapons and go up there and knock the shit out of them. So consider it a community building exercise.
It on from what's his name, Oka Kami or whatever his name is. He was sick and tired of being the only one who has to do it for 3 days because people don't band up, people just stop farming. And he actually wants to do something, but he can't.
Okay, and so no maybe there should be a guild that's for protection of the crown or something, or for anti-abuse of the crown. You know, maybe somebody needs to take that up in their role play, that's why they're put on this, you know, island is to make sure that the king acts honorably and remove the king when they don't. I don't know. I think it can all be role played out, and I think it pisses people off. I watch other streamers that they get on a brand new server, king jacks it up to 20%, and they're like, "You prick," you know. And so if you want to be remembered as a prick, that's a good way to start.
Just wanted to throw it out there too that you know, like I mentioned before, I've been on several different role playing games for quite a while, and DayZ RP, for example, extremely, extremely successful, made tens of thousands of dollars on donations, and they have a page or two of rules that everyone has to follow, mm-hmm. and if they don't, then they're banned.
So but if we have some places like that that have some good rules that we can glean some stuff from to use for ours, post a link in the forums. I'd love to see that. We'll take a look at them, and we'll see what makes sense to add. I'll also say the fewer number of rules that we have, the better.
Yeah, because this is what I was about to say. Keep in mind, Markee, we talked about that. The more rules you add, the more work to do you have at the end. So
right.
You're ending up in just checking everything. Is that right? Is that not right? And then your full day is just gone for banning people, checking up on people, and so on and so on. It's a pain.
It is a pain, but it needs to be done.
Yeah, but for that you need more moderators at the end.
Exactly.
And we're going to work on the permissions for that. Brian sent me something which I'm going to look at, and we'll see what we can do for that, so that we can have people helping with the whitelist stuff, and that we can have people with the ability to ban, and then. You know, I don't know if there's other abilities that are needed, but, you know, I can take a look at all the administrative abilities, and if there is something that's needed, then maybe we can make a category for that. So.
I'll throw a link in TeamSpeak here.
Actually, post it in the forums.
Okay.
That way everybody can take a look at it, even those that are watching, and we can, you know, talk about it over the next few days in the forums if there's some good points in there that we want to discuss. So, Boca, my wife, she actually has done a lot of searching for other Reign of Kings communities and whether or not they had some good rules and stuff, and a few of those things have made it into our rules. So okay. Let's see here. I guess I don't have anything else. Yeah, Alex makes a very good point. And everyone's interpretations of the rules are different. It's such a hard thing. That's why I like my one rule that I have on the stream for the most part, which is don't be a dumbass. And that's pretty much the only rule. And then just leaves it up to the interpretation of the mod or me as to whether or not they're being a dumbass. And we move on. There's not a whole lot of consequences to it, because, you know, what can we do? We just ban somebody from the chat on the show. And there's not much consequence in real life to that for any of us other than the one person. And typically when somebody, you know, then messages me and says, "Oh, I was dumb. I shouldn't have done that. Can you let me back in?" I let them back in. Or if they state some case that they think that they're wrongfully banned, I a lot of times give them a second chance. Second time of being a dumbass and they're gone for good. But obviously it's too complex in this game to use that single rule. So. Okay, any other thoughts? Otherwise, we'll get to some gameplay.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So the only final thing is that Saturday we're going to have a new server coming online, and I'll post in the announcements when it's up. You'll see it if you do a search for Markee Saturday morning my time.
Welcome to the Dragons.
And then the existing server that we have at that point is going to switch over to like a hardcore PvP where everybody must roleplay, but no holds barred. That's going to be the only rule that, you know, everybody must roleplay. So if you're looking for a lot of war or whatnot, that'll be a good chance to do that, because there'll be no holds barred. Then we'll continue with the new server, which will be a 40-man server. And we won't wipe it unless we absolutely have to, and we'll try and manage it and keep it going as long as we can without having to do a wipe. And about a week after that one comes online, then we'll have an event server, and I'll start a thread where we can all post ideas on what our first event can be, and the event server will run for a week or two on the server, and then, I don't know, be some sort of conclusion, whether it's a contest, whether it's, you know, it's votes, or whether it's an all-out war or whatever, and then it gets wiped and we try the next special event. So I'm hoping some good things will come out of that we actually might be able to try some things that we may want to try on the main server, but we've been in conflict, we haven't been able to come to any definite decisions on, and maybe we can prove some of those things out in there one way or another, whether some stuff's a good idea or a bad idea. So that's my thoughts.
And let's hope we'll see some patches from the game developer.
Yes, I really hope so. I really hope we see some updates from the game developer. We really need we need these tools, you know? I'm sure that they're just trying to combat exploits. That's all they're working on right now. Because the public servers are absolutely horrible, and that's why we built our own community instead of just saying, hey, everybody join, you know, US 131 or whatever, you know? That's why we have our own servers.
I posted that on the forums. I got to go now, but thanks for the talk, everybody. Thanks
for keeping thank you. Civil. Yep. Okay, so that's it for that. We're going to switch over to doing actual gameplay now. So, mm-hmm. I know, yeah, there was one guy in chat that kept saying, just go out and kill people. I want to see some action. Yeah, okay. We'll get to that. So, thanks for your input, everybody. And I'm going to add two rules a little later today, or one rule, that a mic is required. And we didn't have any other things that we came up with, did we? Nothing conclusive. Just
not really.
What's that?
Adult. I don't know.
Oh, adult. That's already in there. It's already in there. Yeah. Oh, and I'm adding the special word that that all new applicants must state, otherwise they're just denied. And they won't be told why they're denied. Their application will just be denied. So the smart ones will get it. So, okay. We have plenty of people in right now. Oh, and if anybody is being an asshat in game, like dumb, like violating rules or whatnot, please turn them in so that we can take care of them. And if there's any kids on the servers, please turn them in. And we'll remove them from the whitelist. So.
No kids.
Right, right. What, does that take you out? Kid? You're a kid. Yeah. You're not a kid.
Here we are.
Well, my daughter wanted to play, damn it.
Ah, right. Yeah. How old's your daughter?
She's 10.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's going to... Yeah, it's gonna be a problem on that, but I think that statistically, if we keep it to adults, we're gonna have much fewer problems. So, and I know that sucks. It sucks for some of the kids, but
I just wanted her to build my base, you know.
Yeah, no, I get that. I get that. My wife has hired the kids. You know, hey, I'll give you a quarter if you'll mine all this ore for me in Minecraft.
Exactly. There you go.
Yep. Yep. So, okay. Okay, I'm muting you guys. Thank you. And, okay, so give me just a minute. We're going to switch over, and we're going to actually get into some gameplay and have some fun. So give me 2 or 3 minutes, and we'll do that. I'll be right back.
Welcome to the Dragons.
Now that I have you standing here, I must confess my sin. I've always loved you ever since the day we shared the same air. I've always loved you ever since the day we shared.
Okay, so, you know, it's really interesting how we have so many varying opinions, and we can't seem to come up with consensus.